How weird is that?
Today's topic, objects that can actually attract. Or objects that can actually repel. That you didn't think were magnetic. That's right, today's episode is about magnetic fruit. Welcome to Impossible Science. Hey everyone, it's Jason Latimer, world champion of magic, coming to you with another Impossible Science, the show where we take an impossible topic and we bring it to life through science. Now today's topic, magnetic fruit. Now what you just saw with the banana and the lemon and the strawberry, that is an illusion, but that doesn't mean it's impossible. In fact, today I'm gonna prove to you that your fruit is magnetic and it's gonna blow your mind. Today we're learning about different magnetic materials. Now most people are familiar with ferromagnetic materials. This magnet is attracted to the iron in this nail. Now, if you've ever played with a magnet before, you know that opposites attract and like charges repel. But when you're dealing with iron versus a magnet, regardless of the orientation, whether it's north or south pole, ferromagnetic materials are attracted to the magnet. Cool, right? And it's a pretty strong force. I mean, it's enough to actually defy gravity. But there's other types of magnetic materials, paramagnetic and diamagnetic materials. Both of them are very weak forces. And without getting into the quantum mechanics of how they actually work, paramagnetic materials are always attracted to a magnet, and diamagnetic materials are repelled from a magnet. But again, a very weak force. Diamagnetic repels, paramagnetic attracts. Paramagnetic materials are gonna be stuff like aluminum, platinum, manganese, and diamagnetic materials is something like gold, copper, silver, zinc, but also water. Yeah, water is diamagnetic. This next experiment is gonna blow your mind. Now for this experiment, I'm gonna be using a neodymium magnet. Now it has to be this type of magnet because this is extremely strong. If you use the little black magnets that you find on your refrigerator, it won't be strong enough. Definitely get one of these. You can get them at a hardware store. You might find smaller ones and you can stack them together. But for me, I'm gonna be using a 1-inch neodymium magnet. And I took a beaker and I filled it up with just water here. And it's just sitting on foam right now to float on the water. And I'm gonna put this magnet really close to it, but I'm not gonna touch it. And I'm gonna see if I can push this beaker across the water. It's going, see if I can build the momentum. That's so cool. So we know water is repelling from the magnet because it's diamagnetic. Well, fruit has water in it. Since water is diamagnetic, that means fruit that have a lot of water in them will repel from a magnet. We're gonna see these forces using this. This is what's known as a torsion pendulum. It sounds really fancy, but really what I'm doing is suspending this little stick using really thin thread. I tried fishing line, but it seemed to be a little too rigid, so it would twist up. This allows us to see very, very weak forces. I'm just gonna put a grape on each end of this torsion pendulum. You can use a straw, you can use a stick, but the real secret is to get them to balance. Ta-da! Now, with this setup, we should be able to see the grape repel from the magnet. So let's give it a shot. There it goes.
How weird is that?
Your fruit is magnetic, diamagnetic. So if it repels water, how about ice? We know water is diamagnetic and we know the fruit is diamagnetic because of the water, which means ice should be diamagnetic. So I decided to just freeze some ice cubes and stick them on each side of the stick. I have to work quickly because it's melting. Let's get this head to repel. It's working, it's just melting so much. See if I can just get it to a teeter back and forth. How crazy is that? So we've seen a lot of diamagnetic material, whether it was water, water in fruit, or ice. But what about paramagnetic material? The stuff that actually will attract towards a magnet, but it's just a super weak force. Well, we can use the same device here, this torsion pendulum, to actually see a paramagnetic material. We're gonna just crimple these into a ball. I'm doing this so that you guys know there's nothing inside this aluminum. And then I'll put another one over here. And hopefully this magnet is strong enough to attract the aluminum. Because remember, this is paramagnetic, weak force that attracts. Diamagnetic is weak force that repels. So let's try it. It's working! And there you have it, magnetic aluminum. Well, it was always magnetic. It just wasn't strong enough to see it. We just made the impossible possible through science. We found out that aluminum is paramagnetic. We found out that water is diamagnetic. We found out that fruit will actually repel from a magnet because it's diamagnetic because of the water. And if that blew your mind, make sure you let me know. Click the like button, share this video with your friends. And if you want to learn about more goofy experiments, make sure you subscribe to the channel. And until next time, stay curious, because the right question changes everything.